to work until you're 80 years old. You know, there are a lot of people that are working at 80 years old because they have to. And because they didn't have someone to tell them that you could start from where you are, and they had that, they missed that opportunity because they never had someone to tell them how to do it. Okay? So I'm here to tell you that you can do it. You can do it. So I think just having that commitment to take advantage of your company's retirement plan. That's really important. And if your company offers a match, you can't walk away from free money. If your company is offering you a match of up to 6% of what you're putting away, at the very least, make sure you're doing 6%. If you're not doing 6%, you're leaving money on the table. Can't afford to do that. Does anybody know the amount that you can put away when you're under 50? Pre-tax in a 401k or a 403b. What do you think that amount is, the maximum amount that you can put away pre-tax in a 401k? Someone said 15, someone said 5. It's actually $18,000 for 2015.
Wow.
That's correct. So it's $18,000 if you're under 50. And if you're over 50, they have a catch-up provision. Because they realize that, you know what, maybe a lot of individuals over 50 are really trying now to play catch-up. You know, for whatever reason, they didn't have the opportunity to put away as much money. Now they're getting closer to retirement. You're 50 now, and you can almost see and taste retirement down the road. The government gives you an opportunity to make an additional contribution, and you can actually contribute $23,000 per year pre-tax in a 401k or a 403b plan. So definitely take advantage of it. At the very least, what I say is put away the maximum that you can comfortably put away. And every year you get a raise, or every year perhaps commit to increasing that by 1% or 2%. But at the very least, put away something. If you can do the match, please do the match. But at the very least, commit to putting away something. It's money that you're not going to see. You actually reduce your taxable income by what you contribute to a 401k or a 403b. But the 401ks are the most significant opportunity for building long-term wealth. It really is. So it's about committing to save as much as you can in your prime earning years. That's what it's about. Because we know the years come up very fast upon us. And the biggest regret that I hear from older clients that I meet is, I wish I had saved more. So take advantage of the fact that you have the magic of time on your side. Learn about investments. There's so much information out there now on the internet or otherwise. There's really no reason that you shouldn't take it upon yourselves, go to the library, get a book, and learn a little bit about the various investment vehicles for building long-term wealth. That's really important. Any questions so far? Yes?
What about an IRA?
Okay, I'm getting to that. Good. So if your company does not offer a 401k, or if you're self-employed, there are various pre-tax or retirement vehicles that you can invest in to also build wealth. If you are married and you're not working, a spouse can set up an IRA for you, an individual retirement plan, is the acronym, what the IRA is. And the IRA, again, is another vehicle by which you can put away money pre-tax. The fundamental difference between the IRA and the 401k plans is that the IRA, you can only put aside a maximum of $6,000 a year. So the contribution limits are a lot lower, but at least it's available, right? So for a 401, for an IRA, if you're under 50, it's actually $5,500 is the maximum contribution. And if you're over 50, the government gives you an extra $1,000 in a catch-up, so you can put $6,500. So because there's such a huge difference between that number, the pre-tax contribution between the 401k, 403b, and the IRA, that's why the 401ks and the 403bs are so powerful, because you can put aside so much and then you get a match. That's how you really can build wealth. But at the very least, an IRA gives you the opportunity to start to set aside money systematically for your retirement. And you can open up an IRA at any bank. You don't need to open up an IRA at a brokerage. You don't need a brokerage relationship to open up an IRA. Any bank, local bank, you can start an IRA. And sometimes you can start an IRA with as little as $500. You don't need a lot of money to start an IRA. The most important thing is you can make a contribution if you're under 50 of $6,500 up to 100% of your earnings. So for example, if you work a part-time job and you may, let's say you're not really, you're working but you don't need the income, it's just a part-time job and perhaps you're married and there's money coming in to meet your living expenses, you can make a contribution up to 100% of your income up to $6,500, okay? And that's with the IRA. The important point is that with any of those retirement vehicles, whether it's a 401k or the IRA, if you touch that money before you're 59 and a half, right, there's a penalty. So you really want to commit to not touching that money. Just tell yourself that this is money that you're building for that day when you're going to stop working. Because no one really wants to work beyond a certain time. You know, you figure, okay, you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know how you're going to feel. You might say to yourself, you know what, I'm going to work, you know, I'm going to work for as long as I can. Well, you know what, maybe God has other plans.
Hey, yeah.
You know, you don't know what your health is going to be like. You don't know what could happen in terms of a disability that might take you out of the workforce. So strike while the iron is hot.
Yes.
When you have the opportunity where you're earning an income, just commit to putting aside money systematically during your prime earning years, because you don't know when that's going to change. Someone had a question. Yes.
Just for purposes of making sure everyone understands what you're saying, mm-hmm. You're talking about pre-tax.
Okay.
So can you tell, mm-hmm. explain sure. what that is and what the significance of that is?
Sure. So let's say you make $25,000 or $20,000 a year. Let's put a number out there. So let's say you make $20,000 a year. If you put in $6,000 in an IRA, your taxable income then would be $14,000. That's what you're going to report to the government. Because that $6,000 that you put away in that retirement plan or in that 401k does not count as income. So you have the benefit of being able to shelter that money for as long as it grows on a tax-deferred basis. And that's for an IRA. There's also a Roth IRA. Familiar with the Roth IRA? So the difference is that the Roth IRA is after-tax money. So you don't get a deduction on your income when you invest money in a Roth IRA. However, here's the citron. So with a Roth IRA, even though you don't get a pre-tax deduction on the income, all the growth in an IRA, when you're ready to pull it out, it's completely tax-free.
Right.
So it's like in one, you get the break up front, but when you pull it out in a traditional IRA, when you're past 59 and a half without a penalty, Uncle Sam then says, with his tip cup, I've allowed you the opportunity to put aside this money pre-tax in a 401k or an IRA for the last 20 years or 30 years. Now that you're going to be pulling money out, I need to get my share. So that's a 401k, 403b, traditional IRA. Whereas a Roth and many 401k plans now offer you the ability to contribute money after tax in a Roth. So the difference is you don't get the tax break. So if you put $20,000, if you put $6,000 in a Roth IRA and you make $20,000, you still have to report $20,000 in income. You don't get the deduction. However, every year that you contribute and you continue to build and grow that Roth IRA, when you are 59 and a half, or whenever you decide to pull it out past 59 and a half without a penalty, there's no taxes. You pay no taxes on that money. The traditional IRA also, when you're 70 and a half, and I don't know how the government comes up with these half numbers and these half ages, but they do, okay? So when you're 70 and a half and you've invested money in a 401k or an IRA, the government says you have to start to take a required minimum distribution. So there are a lot of individuals who I have as clients who, you know, rolled over money from a 401k in an IRA, and I'll talk a little bit about what a rollover means. So they have money sitting in an IRA, and really, they have good pension incomes. They've got other investments, their home is paid off, etc., and they really don't need the income from that IRA. And so many of them at 70 and a half, you know, they're forced to take out the required minimum distribution, even though they don't need it. But it's the government saying, okay, this money has been growing pre-tax for God knows how many years. At 70 and a half, we must get a share of what you pull out. So the government makes you take out a distribution. And it's generally a very low amount. It's not a lot. It's about maybe 3 to 4% of the overall assets in the IRA. All right, so it's not a lot because it's a calculation based on that person's life expectancy. So the government will keep the calculation is based on whatever you pull out when you die at 80 years old, that IRA will be close to being depleted, is really where that number comes from. All right, so it's really important to kind of decide which is the best way for you to go. Because there are certain income restrictions that don't allow you to put money in a Roth. So the traditional IRA is generally the vehicle that most people use, or a 401k or a 403b to build money long term. Okay. Any questions? You know what, I don't know it off the top of my head, but I want to say it's quite low. It's quite low. I want to say it's probably somewhere around, if you're filed individually, somewhere around $75,000. And if you file joint, it might be $150,000. So, you know, it's low, the threshold. Okay. Yes.
I just wanted to make a comment. When you said when people get a raise, I've heard that if you get a raise, you should just save that money because act like you didn't have it.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And that's a good way to start building.
Yeah, absolutely. So, young woman, what's your name?
Jocelyn.
Jocelyn just said, you know, when you get a raise, you should really commit to just saving it. And that's one way that you can commit to increasing that percentage amount with your 401k or your 403b investments, okay? So I've been given a 5-minute warning here, so I'm gonna try to speed this along. The other thing that I wanted to talk about is, and you might have touched upon it in terms of debt and credit cards, but
yes.
My philosophy is take charge of your credit cards.
Thank you.
Take charge. You do the taking charge.
There you go. Stop charging.
I work. This is a second career for me. I started out in retail. I was a buyer for the gourmet company, and so I came out of the world of merchandising. And I'm telling you, I'm going to tell you a secret. The retailers have figured out to a T how to rope you in.
Say it.
When you go to a department store or anywhere you're making a purchase, they have trained those salespeople to just simply say, "Can I have your telephone number, please?" And what did most of you do? You give up your telephone number. Your telephone number is as unique to you as your social security number. Nobody else on this planet has your telephone number, your exact telephone number. Don't give up your power. Because you give up your telephone number or your email. Now, many of them are asking you for your emails. It's the same thing. That's the way that they're able to track your spending habits. Okay? Be able to send you emails to tell you there's a one-day sale today. There's a one-day sale every day. You're not missing anything. But the stores have figured out how to rope you in. They figure out that when there's music playing in the lobby, okay, it causes you to shop more. Okay? They figured out that when you walk onto the lobby, most every department store has the makeup and all the accessories on the first floor. Yeah. And that's very well thought out. They do that for a reason, because those are impulse purchases.
Right.
The lipstick and the earrings and the shoes. There's a reason why it's on the first floor, because that's how they rope you in. Those are impulse purchases. So I want you to be really conscious of how they try to get us, how they try to rope you in. What I started doing is, when I get the Macy's circulars and circulars from the store, I have a bag right at my garage door, and that's where they all get dumped. I don't even bring them in my house. You gotta figure out a way to change how they have been brainwashing us to buy and spend.
That's right.
And fill up our closets with stuff. When at the end of the day, you're wearing the same thing in your closet week after week. There's stuff that you have in your closet that you probably haven't worn in 3 or 4 or 5 years. So I think it's really important to understand that you are empowered. You can be empowered to make different choices about how you spend your money. When you walk into that department store, you walk in and be very focused about what you need to get, and you just tell yourself, y'all ain't gonna get me today. You're not gonna get me today. And I think it's really about understanding your power. Claim your power back. Claim your power back. The next time they ask you for your email or your telephone number, you can just say very politely, "I'd rather not, thank you." Simple. And delete all those emails that you're getting now from the stores. Just delete them all, because again, that's another way that they rope you in. Okay? Don't let them get the best of you. You take control. You've got the power. Okay? And understand again that you simply start what? Where do we start from? Start from where you are. That's what I will leave you with here this morning. I want to thank you for having me. It's been a pleasure to share and have you with me. I hope that I've left you with some tidbits that you can walk away with, that perhaps you can do something immediately to make some changes in terms of your financial well-being.
Yes.
Thank you.